Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi was born on October 2, 1869, to parents Karamchand Gandhi and Putlibai Gandhi. He was commonly referred to as Mahatma or Great Soul. It also could stand for Venerable. It was his first used in 1914 but remained with him throughout his life. He was raised in a Hindu family in Western India. His father was a chief minister for local administrators, and his mother was a deeply religious housewife whom the young Gandhi loved and admired greatly. Enrolling in school at the age of 9, he proved to be an average student who shied away from other kids and kept to himself. While still in high school, his brother's friends tried to persuade him to get Mohandas to eat meat to gain weight and height. He was even taken to a brothel to exercise his manhood. He tried meat, but was too shy to participate in the brothel, and subsequently was kicked out of the brothel. As a result, he stopped speaking to his older brother and his friends. In May of 1883, the 13-year-old Mohandas and a 14-year-old girl named Kasturbai Makanji Kapupadia, or Ba, as Gandhi affectionately called her, were wed in a ceremony, including two other couples. The arranged marriage did come with discord, however. The young couple argued incessantly, mostly due to Mohandas' jealous and controlling habits. In 1885, she bore their first child, who died just days after his birth. The Gandhis were to have four children, Harilal, Manilal, Ramdas, and Devdas. In 1888, not knowing what to do since dropping out of college, the young Mahatma was persuaded to pursue law and enroll in law school in London by a family friend named Mavji Dev Joshiji. To persuade his mother to let him go, he took a solemn vow in front of her to abstain from cigarettes, alcohol, meat, and women. She finally consented, and on August 10th, he set sail to London from Porbandar. At first, it was hard to abstain from English cuisine since it was so readily available. Mohandas would often go to bed hungry or eat small amounts of jam, butter, and bread. While staying in London, he was able to find a few decent vegetarian restaurants, and his appetite was quickly restored. He also became a member of the London Vegetarian Society, even becoming a member of its executive committee. In June of 1891, by the age of 22, Gandhi was called to the bar. His first big client was representing a cousin of a wealthy Muslim merchant in South Africa. It was this time in Gandhi's life that were to be the most valuable for him, developing his skills of being a lawyer. His 21-year stay in South Africa were to be riddled in setbacks, discrimination, and racism. In 1915, he was to return to India permanently with a renewed sense of purpose and an outlook far different than the one in which he came. Gandhi soon joined the Indian National Congress and in 1920 was its leader. The Congress announced its independence in 1930, a declaration that the British didn't recognize, but was to get the ball rolling in terms of negotiations. In March of 1930, Gandhiji would lead a march to the sea to make salt in defiance of a law prohibiting natives to make, sell, or distribute sea salt. The protest resulted in 2 deaths and 60,000 imprisoned, including the future First Prime Minister of India, Jawaharlal Nehru, and that of the Mahatma himself. By this time, Gandhi was a folk hero and an international celebrity, being adored and sought after by millions who have read of him or heard of him on the news. The downtrodden especially revered him. Miss Slade, daughter of an English admiral, joined him in the struggle from British dominance. She was to live with him as a surrogate daughter. He renamed her Mirabai, and she would remain loyal to him to the very end. In March of 1931, Gandhi went into negotiations once again with the British. The Gandhi-Irwin Pact, so named after Lord Irwin and Gandhi, stated that the British government was to release all political prisoners in exchange for a temporary cessation of the civil disobedience movement. The pact was successful, and both parties were satisfied with the outcome. The ensuing years would see the aging Gandhi consumed by conferences, meetings, short imprisonments, and the death of his beloved wife in 1944. On August 15, 1947, a lifelong dream of his was finally achieved, for India obtained her independence from British rule. Gandhi spent the day fasting and spinning, choosing not to celebrate with the newly formed nation. On January 30, 1948, while walking to a prayer meeting, Mahatma Gandhi was shot 3 times at point-blank range from a 9mm, killing him almost instantly. A Hindu extremist, Nathuram Godse, was apprehended at the scene and subsequently, despite the Gandhi family's strong disapproval, executed by hanging on November 15, 1949. If you like my channel, please hit subscribe and hit that like button. There's definitely more to come. Thank you.